Section 5.3, Creating and Registering Archives. When you create archives, you can name them using any naming standard you want. Just, we suggest you come up with some kind of a site standard for that. They can be stored in any directory, although typically people put them in the PI/DAT directory. And we always suggest that you disable virus scanning software from looking at those archive directories. We've actually had customers who, just because of the way the archive is writing in a proprietary binary format, we've actually seen people get false positives of viruses because of just the combination of characters being written to disk. So you normally want to exclude that. It also will, of course, slow your system down because we are constantly writing to those archives. So it's not a good idea. It's going to be constantly thrashing, checking those archives for viruses. Yeah. So creating archives, you can create these using the system management tools, as I'm going to demonstrate in just a second. You would use this tool right here to create a brand new archive. So let me go ahead and demonstrate. I'll go ahead and create a brand new archive. This is my test server, currently sorted by the archive number, and I'll create a brand new archive. And you have some choices here. We have a choice of where we're going to put it, what we're going to call it. As you can see, we've consistently keeping consistent with the naming convention that we started when we did the install. But there's no reason you can't change that. I'm going to call this myarc1.dat. There's really no reason you can't change it at all. Now, I would normally choose clone the primary archive and at a fixed size. We'll talk more about fixed versus the other types of archives. I simply want something at the same size, but if I wanted to, I could create one larger. So for example, 128 megabytes, that's going to give me at least, I'd be able to create at least 64,000 tags. If for some reason I needed to get bigger than that, I may go to 256 megabytes or something like that. I'm just going to clone this. And you do have the option to create an archive that has a specific start and end time, and that can be either fixed or dynamic. Now, the difference between the two has to do with whether we can increase the size as we fill it or not. And I'll explain more about dynamic archives a little bit later. Typically, you would always choose fixed archives, you know, that are going to be using the current times. But for backfilling purposes, if you've got data that needs to go into an older time slot, you can actually create these fixed or dynamic archives that have those old times for recovery purposes. We actually don't cover backfilling in this class. It's part of our System Manager 2 class. And I'll go ahead and hit OK. And now I've created that archive. You see there's the new archive. And currently it is registered. I'll go ahead and registered for me automatically. I'll sort. Now it is the highest empty archive, and as such, it's the destination of the next shift. Take a look here where we say shift prediction. As you can see, this is now going to be the destination of the next shift, this myarc1.dat. Now it's only when an archive is registered that PI really knows anything about that, and you can register and unregister that archive from PI SMT. We don't have to register the archive that I just created, because when you create the archive from SMT, it's registered already. If you notice, though, I can unregister it, and it disappears. It's not in the list of archives we know about. Now, when it's in that unregistered state, at that point, it belongs to you. You can do anything you want to it. You can move it around. You can rename it. You can move it to a different location and then register it in that new location. However, when it's registered, it does belong to PI, so you shouldn't do any of that moving or renaming. So I'm going to go ahead and register this now. This was called myarc1.dat. And now it shows up again. I'll go ahead and sequence this again, 0 through 3. And here's our archives. Now, in addition to doing it from the system management tools, you can also do it from the command prompt. So there's a utility, PI ARTool-, for example, AR for archive register, AU for archive unregister, and if you simply pass the name of the archive, this was called myarc1.dat, you'll notice that is going to unregister that archive. And in fact, over here, when I refresh this, my archive's no longer registered. So that is a way to unregister, or you can register this from the DOS prompt. Not terribly useful, except if you need to create some kind of a batch file to register hundreds of archives at a time. That can be fairly useful.